Each year, more than 12 million young Indian citizens enter the domestic workforce, most of them low-skilled workers, which the Indian job market does not have the capacity to accommodate. Enter the Make in India initiative. Launched by Prime Minister Modi in September 2014, Make in India is an attempt to transform India into a global design and manufacturing hub. By shifting focus to the manufacturing center, the initiative hopes to create more jobs for low-skilled workers in addition to bringing more FDI into the country. My name is Lauren, and this is Asiapedia, Discover Asia's Business Environment. In today's podcast, we are discussing India's Make in India initiative and what it means for the country. I'm joined by Melissa, senior editor for our New Delhi office in India here today.
Hi, Lauren. It's nice to be here today and be part of the podcast.
So, Melissa, what's so important about Make in India? What does it mean for the country?
Well, that's an interesting question. So why Make in India? Why now? Well, number one, we import less, especially from China, so being able to manufacture our own goods is important. Two, Make in India creates jobs. As you mentioned previously in your introduction, India has a shortage of openings for low-skilled workers. Kickstarting India's lagging manufacturing sector can create jobs for those that need employment and jobs that also require upskilling. And thirdly, the Make in India initiative represents important opportunities for foreign investors, making it easier for them to invest directly in Indian companies.
The Make in India initiative is in its fourth year now, so we're going to take a look at how it's impacted and will continue to impact India's economy. Let's start by looking at the country's electronic system and the design manufacturing center in particular. India's rising disposable incomes, along with digitization, has resulted in a strong domestic consumer demand for electronics. However, almost 75% of this demand is currently being serviced through imports.
That's right, and with demand far outstripping supply, it's no wonder the Indian government has pushed for more local manufacturing and assembling units. In fact, they have introduced industry-wide incentives, loosened FDI rules, and increased import duties, all in the hopes to reduce all electronic imports by 2020.
And their plans to do so have paid off so far. In June of this year, Chinese electronics company Xiaomi's investment in the smartphone manufacturing center brought nearly 50,000 job opportunities to India.
Yes, and since 2016, the Chinese company has set up six other manufacturing plants across the country. Other Chinese companies, such as Huawei and the Lenovo Group, have also increased the local production of their mobile phones in India.
Now, some companies have pointed to Make in India's encouragement of FDI as influencing their decision to begin local production. Policy changes have removed barriers to foreign investment, improved ease of doing business, and encouraged the development of infrastructure and the workforce.
Yes, and that last point is very important. India needs FDI for building infrastructure around the country, as its domestic private sector is reluctant to invest due to being fiscally strained or overly cautious. Since Make in India was announced 4 years ago, countries such as Sweden and South Korea, in addition to India, have renewed their interests and lead foreign investor interests into the country. In April of this year, Prime Minister Modi met with Swedish Prime Minister Stefan Löfven to strengthen trade and investment ties. He pitched Make in India. In fact, the last 10 years, more than 110 Swedish firms have begun operations in India and view the country as a bright manufacturing spot. Employment through Swedish firms and investments increased 20% last year alone in India. Today, Swedish companies directly employ nearly 200,000 Indians and provide jobs in an indirect capacity to over 1.6 million Indians across the country. Prime Minister Modi also pitched Make in India when he was visiting with South Korean President Moon Jae-in in July this year. The two countries now plan to increase trade and investment between them to $50 billion by 2030, which will see an increase from about $30 billion from today.
In regard to FDI, Make in India has had its successes in the electronic system and design manufacturing industry, which we spoke about earlier. There have been significant investments by a number of smartphone makers. Within the automotive industry, the Make in India campaign has highlighted automatic approval for foreign equity investment of up to 100% with no minimum investment criteria and exceptions from licensing and approvals for manufacturing and imports. In turn, major foreign players such as BMW, Volvo, and Ford have announced plans to localize manufacturing and increase investment. Raising the FDI cap for defense manufacturing up to 49% has also caused a flurry of investment activity in the industry, while the solar industry is projected to be a $100 billion investment magnet over the next 7 years.
But while there has been success with the Make in India initiative, it has had a patchy and rather subdued impact on the Indian economy so far. While the initiative succeeded in creating new buzz for investing in India, it hasn't been able to transform it into any significant rise in manufacturing activity. In fact, recent shocks delivered by poorly implemented demonetization and GST rollout last year, in fact, dampened investor sentiment on the ground, almost neutralizing Make in India's impact. Further, the global value chains that ushered in manufacturing hubs in East Asia are now rapidly transforming. Businesses no longer rely on cheap labor for production purposes. They're now instead adopting technologies such as 3D printing and smart automation. And while India's rank in the World Bank's Ease of Doing Business Index has risen, not many business people will say that business in India has gotten any easier.
So, Melissa, what does this mean for investors looking to India?
Well, at the same time, it's not all doom and gloom for investors looking at India. The country's economic growth, although tempered by recent misadventures, is still on the up. India has a huge market like China, one that you cannot afford to ignore, a growing labor force that seeks to be more skilled and is finding more avenues to do so, and reforms targeting tax, removing bureaucratic hurdles for businesses, easing FDI caps, innovation and logistics infrastructure, and making land available more easily. Another interesting aspect is the increasing competition between India's states to attract investments in respective industrial sectors. All of this will improve doing business in India overall, as well as the choices for foreign investors looking at where to invest in India and how.
Okay, Melissa, thank you so much for being here today with us. Now, if you would like to know more about Make in India, you can check out our website, India Briefing, for more articles written by Melissa and our great team of editors. You can also visit the Zan Shear & Associates Asiapedia page for more resources on doing business in India. Thanks for listening with us today.